Hello everyone, welcome to this channel. I am Preeti and in this video we will see what is TDS and how to enable TDS in Power Platform Admin Center. So first of all, what is TDS? It stands for Tabular Data Stream in the Power Platform Admin Center. We can connect to the dataverse and have access to the data in Power Platform environments with the help of this endpoint. So whenever we are using the dataverse connector, so the TDS is required for the connecting the dataverse to Power BI. So TDS is nothing but a feature that we need to enable in Power Platform Admin Center while we are working with the Power BI. So we can connect to this dataverse and have access to the data in Power Platform environments with the help of this endpoint. This endpoint offers read-only access to the system for reporting and analytics. TDS endpoint management falls under the purview of system administrator. The nice thing is that you can access the data according to the security roles Power Platform Admin Center has assigned you. It is a common knowledge that reports on the datasets are produced using the Power BI desktop. So you may connect to Power Platform environments from the Power BI desktop and create Power BI dashboards and reports with the native security. So next we will see how we can enable and disable this TDS endpoint in the Power Platform Admin Center. So first of all, we need to open the Power Platform Admin Center. So how we can open it? Just we can use this link, like https://admin.powerplatform.microsoft.com/home. So just enter it. So once you will enter this link, you need to sign in. You need to sign in using valid credential, Microsoft 365 credential. If you didn't sign in before, then you can sign in and come to this page. So this is the Power Platform Admin Center home page. Here you can see the environments in the left navigation. Just click on it. Once we will click on the environments, it will display us all the environments in our Power Platform Admin Center. So where we need to enable the TDS point, just select that specific environment. Here I need to enable the TDS endpoint in my environment, that is TDS Info Technologies default. So just select it. Once you will select it, you can see the settings option here. You can click on the settings option. So here just expand the product. Here you can see the features. So just click on it. So here this is the page where you can see all the features in Power Platform Admin Center. Just scroll down. Once you'll scroll down, here you can see the TDS endpoint that helps to and that enables connecting from Power BI using Tabular Data Stream protocol. So by default it will be enabled only. So if it is not enabled, then you need to enable it. Otherwise you cannot connect the dataverse connector to Power BI. So if it is not enabled, then you have to enable it as previously enabled. So that is showing me enable. So what you can do, before it was like in disable mode. Once you will click on enable it, it will be on, and after that you just need to click on the save button, otherwise it will not save. So this is how we can enable the TDS endpoint in Power Platform Admin Center. In the same way, if you want to disable this TDS endpoint in the Power Platform Admin Center, just switch off this toggles icon. So it is already disabled. So now you need to click on the save button. If it will not save, then it will be in enable mode only. So just click on save. So once you will click on save, then it will be in disable mode. So now the TDS endpoint is disabled in Power Platform Admins. Hence, in this approach, we can enable and disable the TDS endpoint in Power Platform Admin Center. If you want to know more details about this thing, then you can visit our site, that is spguides.com. Otherwise, you can get this article link in our description box. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you really like this video, kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit this bell icon button for more videos like this. Thank you so much and have a nice day.